Well, good morning, dear friends. Another tutorial, and today it's going to be doing coasters. I have already got one up online, which is for slate coasters, but today I'm working on cork coasters. So as you can see, I'm going to be doing four, and I've already prepped them with ordinary acrylic paint. They've had three coats because there was a funny sort of design on this side, which I have removed, and it's still cork at the back, but that'll just be sealed. I won't do anything with that. So we're going to be working with these four today. I'll move those ones out of the way. Now, this is the napkin that I am going to be using, which is a very pretty napkin, lovely green. And then the brushes I'm going to be using will be this flathead brush, and that is when I put the napkin on and it's wet, and I put the cellophane over the top, and that just helps to smooth out the creases without damaging the napkin. This one here, slightly wider, quite a hard end brush, not too hard, but a hard end brush. That's for applying the Mod Podge. And I have a smaller one here that I might use as well. This little tiny one, again, quite a softish end brush, that is to use the water to tear the napkin. Then finally, this lovely brush, which is my favorite brush. And this one I always use for applying my final sealant with. It's a lovely smooth brush, and it spreads out very nicely when you're putting on your sealant, so you don't have to keep going over the same area. So those are the brushes I'm going to be using. So we'll take the first one, which is going to be for my wet brush. And then this is one that I have already done the shape to. There's still the three ply. I haven't taken it down to the one ply yet. So once I've laid out roughly the design I want, I'll just put it over the top. So that's what we will do now. I will demonstrate how I get my shape, or the picture that I would like. So I normally put it, the coaster, over the actual picture that I'm looking at. Then I get some water, and I very gently go around the edge, all the way around, just to dampen it down a bit so I can then easily tear it apart. And as you can hear, I don't know if you can hear, but I've got a little bit of country and western on, which I quite enjoy country and western music. That's quite relaxing too. Right, so we go across here like so, then move your coaster. And then now you can actually see where there's the watermark all the way around. Then gently, keeping it flat, putting one finger around the edge or where you're pulling it apart, and just very gently tear. You want a little bit of a overhang, because this we will remove as we end, or before we actually put the sealer on. There we go, all the way around, all the way around. Very, very quick process. We go down here. Here we go. So, oops. That is one done out. And just pop it over the top. Now, it doesn't matter that you've got lots of overhang. As you can see, there's a lot of overhang there, but we deal with that a little bit later once it's secured with Mod Podge and glues and stuff. So I'll carry on doing the rest, and then I'll come back to you in a minute. Right, okay, sorry, wasn't too sure whether my telephone was working properly, my video. Right, okay, so I've cut out all four napkins that I want to use, and now we're going to glue them. So as we do with all napkins, we break it down to just the one ply. So we're going to take this one off. It's one. Found this technique, actually, of wetting your fingers and then just putting them together like so, and it very easily pulls the napkins away. So I used to use my blade, but using it this way is perfect. Now I'm keeping these just in case I want to put them on the back. I'm not sure if I'm going to do that yet, but I'm keeping them to one side. So now we've got the napkin, it's all done. Get a paintbrush. Oops, I'm just going to put my Mod Podge. So we're going to be using Mod Podge as we normally do for the gluing. So we put that on. You can be quite, you know, put on quite a bit, not like loads, but I mean, make sure you get a good coverage. So I normally go around all the sides first. Because again, it doesn't matter if it overhangs. Whoops, got a little hair there. And then down in the middle. And smooth it. Again, like I always do it in one way. Making sure your sides have got the glue. Now, place your napkin where you want it, which is like so. And then you'll pop the cling film over the top and then put your hands together like that. Well, you can do it any way you want, but this is why I do it. I put my hands together and I just spread as the initial spread over. Then I use my flat end brush and I hold the cling film back nice and tight, and then I can just go up and down over the napkin, making sure that I get all of the creases. Again, being a craft, it's not always possible that you can get every single crease out. So you just do your best, and practice makes perfect. So there we go. Once you've done that, peel it back very gently, very, very gently. And then use your hairdryer just to dry that. So excuse me, it's gonna be a bit noisy. And very gently just tap any bubbles that you see coming up. Once it's quite hand dry, you can very gently rub your fingers just up and down it, just to make sure that you've got everything, all the little bumps and any little nooks and crannies. So this is how it is. The back, can you see the overhang? Like we said, we leave that because it gives you plenty to work with. So there's that one ready. Well, it's not ready, but that's the first half of the process. So I will now do the rest of those other ones. Okay, so we're on the last one. And we'll quickly cover with your Mod Podge. When you're doing any decoupage, I don't know if you're like me, or something that you're thinking of trying, you know, it's trial and error as you go through the learning process of it. But over time, you find your own, I've said this many a time in videos, you learn your own technique. You watch the way other people do it, you give it a go. But in the end, you do actually find your own way of putting on your napkins. You know, it might be a long way, it might be a short way, it doesn't matter. You always find your own way. Now, just to quickly just tell you as well, once you put your napkin on and you're doing this last sealing bit here with the cling film, make sure you go round your edges so they are 100% stuck down. If you remember when I glued, I made sure I went right into those edges, because then it takes the napkin over the edge and to the back of the coaster. And again, when you're peeling this off, be very careful that you take it off gently, because otherwise it will rip. Let it really dry. So that is all four have now been done. You've noticed I've done them not all in the same way. We've got two going up ways and we've got two going in a skew-iffy ways. So that's those ones. Now, our next process go back to the original one that you started, because it does take time. I mean, even though they're dried with the hairdryer, it just gives them another 5-10 minutes just to do a little bit more drying. Just cleaning off some of the glue that I have on my bit here. So the next process, this can be a bit of a dodgy one, because as you're putting on the top coat of your glue, the Mod Podge, that will then raise the napkin up. So the main thing when you're applying this part of the glue is don't play with it. Get it on quickly and then move to the next drying area. Otherwise, if you keep going over the same one, your napkin's going to raise up and then you have to start again. So with this time round, don't use too much, not as much as you would use if you're doing the initial first coat on the coaster. So I don't know if you can see, but there isn't like a lot on there. Again, a quick process. So top to bottom, all the way through. And again, top to bottom. Coasters are very good, really, for doing this, because you've got the nice edge of the coaster to work against. Now, don't worry about the corners so much on this particular coat. We can go back to those, to the edges. Now, again, if you're able to, like you saw, I sort of went down, but I don't want to play with that, because you can see that it's starting to come up. I don't know if you can see, if I look, you look closely, you've got a couple of bits that's raised up there. So then what you do is use your hairdryer to dry that up. Now try not to touch it yet. If you do see some bubbles or some creases, just get it to its finger touch. Now that's not too bad. And then tap. Use your finger to tap anything down that you see is sticking up. Around the edges. Now we didn't concentrate on the edges that much with the glue, but don't worry, we will be going back to doing that. Now that is good enough now to be able to put your finger up and down it, nice and dry. So now just to go back around these edges, and then we just give them a very quick go over, and the same at this side. And the same on that side. Again, don't play with it. It's glue on top of glue. Even though the hairdryer is drying it to a certain extent, it's not 100%. The curing time is what makes everything dry nice and hard. You dry that again. Sorry, I've got it on full speed this time. I think we have a little, oh no, it's all right, that was part of the leaf. Right, okay, so that is the first proper Mod Podge coat. So we don't need to do any more to that at the moment. So I will now go and do the rest of these. Okay, so the next process, I have sealed or done the Mod Podge on all four. So now we're going to get rid of this edging where you can see it overhangs. Now I used to cut them, sometimes I still do cut, but other times I actually just use a nail file. Now this is one of the problems you might get, where it will go over the edge and it will get stuck where you've Mod Podged it. So get the nail file. You've got to be fairly quick as you do the motion, and literally I just take the nail file and I go over the edge. You go over it too hard or too much at the same time, you will find that you'll take off all the paint too. You can't help a bit of paint coming off, but that is sort of like a rustic sort of look. It's not too bad. And because the edge is quite a fine edge, you wouldn't really be able to paint it round. So we just use the nail file over the corner and a downward motion. just making sure you get it up so you can easily use a nail file to scrape it down. As you can see, it comes away quite nicely, but the shorter and sharpest way of using your nail file, the better result you get. Go through quite a lot of nail files, as I'm sure you can imagine, and I like to use this sort of pinky clear nail file, because if you use a darker one, which is okay if you're using on dark stuff, but otherwise you'll find that the darkness comes up onto your white paint and then it will make it look quite messy. So nearly there. There we go. So, and then what I normally do is, once I've gone all the way around the edge, as you can see, I then take the flat edge and I just bring the nail file and very gently just go back over to help it smooth it down a bit. Don't be too hard with it, because again, even at this stage, because it's not cured, it's not dried long enough, you still can damage the napkin, believe it or not. So just be very gentle all the time. There we go. So that is one napkin coaster ready for its final sealant coat. That's quite hard, quite durable, as you can hear, and it's nicely smooth. So that's that, and then we'll get on to doing the sealing. Okay, right, so this is all four that have now, I've done all the edges and I've given them a little brush down. So now we're going to give them their sealant coat. Now for that, I use my heavy duty wood varnish, which is brilliant. It's heat resistant it is very hard wearing. So it will take quite a lot of knocks and this type of stuff. So it's very, very good. And it's made by Polyvine. So let's put this in my little jug here. And remember, I'm using this nice flat brush. There, we fill that up. Now this goes a long way. It's very runny, very, very runny. So you don't need to have a lot on your brush. But what I would suggest is make sure that you do soak your brush well to start with. So what I mean by soak your brush is really dip it in there so it gets right into all the bristles, and then wipe it on the side, getting out as much as you can, and then dip it in again, making sure the brush gets nice coverage and all the bristles on the inside of the brush have been covered. So now, once you've done that, just put tip of the brush into your Polyvine, and then starting from, again, going all the way around the edges, making sure you get right into those edges. And then we go up and down, top to bottom. Oh, I normally put my fingernail in the middle of it there to when I'm ready to go back over. Oops, let's get that off there. So that's that one. So they always have, with any of these, when it comes to the coasters, because you know you're probably going to have something hot on them, is that they have three coats of this heat resistant sealant on it. So that's one. And it does dry quite quickly, which is good, because then it's handy for you to keep working on the coaster if you need to do anything else to them. but as far as sealant is concerned, when it's sealed, it will take a good 24 hours for it to be 100% good for use. But for hand dry, to be able to work on your coasters, then you can do it more or less immediately once you've used it with the hairdryer, dried with a hairdryer. Try to keep your last coat of each application going in the same direction, then you won't get any runs and lines. This is a very quick process. Doesn't take very long to do. Like I said earlier, because it's quite runny, it goes a long way. And if you look at an angle, like this angle across, you'll be able to see where you've been. With some sealants, you won't be able, you can't see. It dissolves very quickly. Last one. Remember, not too much on your brush on each application. Really lost it. There we are. And I just noticed, see this, as you go through the process, you do see little bits that you can go back to sort out. I just had a little bit of overhang there. And if you do see anything like that, always remember just to quickly seal around there, just to make sure that anything that you've just had to either tear away or whatever, that it's sealed back down again, so you don't want it rising up. So that's all four, and they've had their first sealant coat. So there we go. So that is all four of them sealed. So they got three coats on the mains ones here. And then at the back of the coaster, I didn't put any napkin on the back. I thought I'd just leave it. So this is just as it is. It's had two coats of acrylic paint, and I put two coats of the heavy duty sealer on there. So it's quite a nice finish. So that is the four coasters all finished, and these will actually be on my main decoupage page for anybody who would like to purchase them. So that's it. Thank you so much again, once again, for joining me. And again, I hope you enjoy my tutorials, and give it a go yourself, because it is an easy process. It's a wonderful thing to do. It's relaxing. So anyway, hope you enjoyed, and thank you so much for being with me today. Thank you. Bye-bye, everyone.